I'd like to welcome Dr. Luis Alonso Pastor, who is a graduate student and research assistant at Changing Places Research Group at MIT Media Laboratory. His topic is, how can 3D printing help with epithelial wound healing? Welcome.
Thank you very much. Yeah, really when the first time that Miguel González Andrades, my good friend from Harvard, Massachusetts Eye and Ear Hospital, came to the lab and say, listen, Luis, we have a problem, but also we have an idea. Then I realized that we was going to have a lot of fun. So we made this small research together. So that's why we can also call this research, how can 3D printing help MIT Changing Places people work with biomedical experts from Harvard. So I think it's a very interesting mix and shows the interdisciplinary way of working on Media Lab. Of course, in the 3D printing side, I want to go like very quickly on the history of 3D printing, because probably all of you knows the history, but it's something that happens in the 1980s. The first patent was in 1980, and only 20 years after that, the first main impact in the biomedical and healthcare field happens. So it's something that happens very quickly. And now for the year 2020, some experts are expecting to this field is going to generate a revenue of $20 billion actually dollars. Of course, the field where we are working, that is a template, so it is a tool. The 3D printed tool and models is going to grow for the year 2025 between $30 and $50 billion per year. So, of course, I say to my friend Miguel, oh, we are going to get rich. No, but of course, we are not getting rich. But the interesting thing is that we also have some interesting problems in the biomedical field. We are working with wounds in the epithelial cells. This is kind of complex, so I'm going to go like very simple on this. Biomedical people are working on in vitro experiments with epithelial cells, but they are working on mostly on monolayer experiments. What we are trying to do is to work with a complex stratified epithelial system, like the skins and cornea, mostly in cornea, because it's where this Harvard friends are most are very focused on, and there are not that much experiments on this. It's very complex to make an in vitro experiment with a stratified epithelial. So, and we are trying to make a wound to make an injury in this skin and see how it performs. For that, that means actually the goals of the research, it was in one side, how can we link this inexpensive and very low cost technology from a very conventional 3D printer and this biomedical challenge? And also, of course, it was how can we make this methodology of working with stratified epithelial skin? So that were kind of the goals. You know, we are Harvard and MIT people, very smart people working together. So we say, oh, we have to make a template as efficient, as eco-friendly as possible. So we, at the beginning, we thought in this kind of template with with a matrix of 300 holes. That was kind of, you know, for the 3D printer, it was too much. And then we start thinking and we jump in something more simple. And we jump into in a 30 hole matrix, that is this picture over here. And then we realized that it was too much for the epithelial skin. The cells were feeling a little bit uncomfortable because they had a lot of holes. So after many iterations, we realized that the best system was only 6 holes. So we deficient sometimes is, you know, after you get deficient after many iterations. That is something that we learned here. And of course, because we was working in the, you know, this eco-friendly, we was working with polylactic acid. So here we can see the issues that we have from the very beginning, the first draft, until we get the template. We went through the problem with the 3D printed and the 300 holes, so it was too much for the printer. But then, because we was working with PLA, when we tried to reuse the template, we have problems cleaning in the autoclave. So we have a polvoron. Polvoron is a sweet from Spain that you have in Christmas time, and it's like no shape. So my good friend Miguel called me, listen, Luis, we was cleaning the template and now we have a polvoron. So I say, well, we have a problem. But we just work with the autoclave and we calibrated, and now it's working perfectly. And the good news is that we make a design in order to be able to make the two different kind of injuries in the skin. One was by rotating and a scratch, and the other one was by punch. So and because we was not able to have the 300 holes in the matrix, we realized that it was much more easier to make a tool that was able to make a easy way of generating these injuries, but also easy way of reproducibility of the experiments and uniformity of the experiment. So we just scaled the experiment to the template. And the good news is that after adding serum, the whole system was working. And after 24 hours, the re-epithelialized of the wounds was working in a 40%. After 48 hours, approximately the 90% was, the cells were growing in a 90%. And after 72 hours, the wound was completely closed. So that means that the experiment worked perfectly. It's not a huge experiment, but we are very happy because we make this work together, MIT, Harvard, and also we was able to link this non very expensive technology from the 3D printers and biomedical needs. And of course, the most important thing is that we have this new methodology in order to work with stratified epithelial cells. I'm not going to get that much time from you. Thank you very much. If you have any questions.
Thank you very much. Thank you.